Damien Schmidt on the Midday Mix.
On the line, I have Sebel, founder of Karasi Clothing. Sebel, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
My absolute pleasure. So, obviously, times are tough. A lot of small businesses have taken a real battering during the COVID-19 pandemic. And for you, you decided to do something a bit different. Tell us a bit about Karasi Clothing.
Well, Karasi Clothing is a business that's based in Johannesburg. And it's a business that I've been running for about 4 years now.
Mm-hmm.
But I think this current year is the year that I felt that I need to put more time and effort and all my energy in my business. And unfortunately, it was the year that we had the pandemic.
Yeah.
So I had to also think of how I can be able to still be busy and be able to still make an impact during this time. So clearly what happened was just that we were having this problem, and I thought, how is the best way I could be able to solve this problem with the resources that I have and the business that I'm doing?
It's an incredible story. So you managed to start a GoFundMe campaign. How did that go about, or how did you go about starting it up, and what was your experience with GoFundMe fundraising?
Yeah. So with GoFundMe, as a South African, you don't have access to it. So it's a platform for Americans. So
mm-hmm.
I had the opportunity to travel to America a few years ago to work there. So as I was chatting to a friend of mine who lives in America, I told her that, hey, I want to start up this GoFundMe account where I want to create funds to be able to help here in South Africa, in a city where I'm living, which is Johannesburg.
Mm-hmm.
And she just said, but do you know that you cannot be able to create a GoFundMe account if you're not an American? And I actually didn't even know this. And she was like, but you know what? I'm actually going to be part of the hosts with you.
So oh, wow.
We were the two organizers on the GoFundMe account. My profile was there, her profile was there, and it also included that she was the person who's running the account in America. And once the funds were done and the donations were done, she was able to transfer the money back here to South Africa.
That's incredible. Now, what were you able to do with the funding that you received via GoFundMe?
Okay, so the whole campaign and the whole donation, we were aiming to make masks. So when you start any donation or any charity organization, you aim to reach as big and as massive as possible.
Yeah.
So we actually had other aims to like help in the people in the entertainment industry, help other fashion designers. But we said the core aim of this fundraising is that anybody who's in the country or out of the country can be able to donate to buy one mask, and with that donation, we'll be able to create a mask. And then if we receive like tons and tons of other donations, then we can do the other goals and the aims we had. But we were able to raise money, which was, we were able to make about 350 masks,
uh-huh.
which amounted to about 22,000 rand. So this was in a space of a month, and this was just really so heartwarming for us as a business.
Yeah.
We were not expecting to reach that much of amount, and yeah, it was amazing.
That's incredible. So you guys are doing a handout today, I believe, in Joburg inner city.
Yeah. So what we did is the campaign was actually in May, and it finished in May. And then in May, we knew how much money we've made
mm-hmm.
and how many masks we needed to produce. And in the whole of June, we were producing masks and also handing out to people, because people needed the mask as well. So we didn't just wait until we were done with the whole 300.
Mm.
But every time we have a 50, we'd go to a place around the city where these like street kids or hobos or people from a shelter who they're gathering up to get food.
Yeah.
We would donate and give out those masks. And today is actually the last day. We have the last 50 masks that we're going to be giving out to people. So hence, we also invited the media people to just know about what we're doing.
Fantastic. Any plans to do this again once you're done?
Well, yeah, that's really great, because with the GoFundMe account as well, the account doesn't go away. So we still are receiving donations from people from everywhere else in the world. And in South Africa, I'm still receiving clients who are buying masks, because what happens is, even here in South Africa, for every mask that you purchase, a 10 rand is donated to the charity organization.
Oh, wow.
So what happens is, as soon as we also can accumulate as much money, we'll still be still donating to people who need masks. Especially right now when it's cold like this, people are really depending on those masks to create that little bit of warmth around their face, around their masks. So it's actually amazing to see how people are enjoying and appreciating these masks.
That's incredible. Seba, how do we get involved if we want to make a donation or just follow your guys' progress?
Okay, thank you. If you would like to also make a donation, please look up us on Instagram and Facebook. The name of the business is Karaci Clothing. It's Caraci Clothing. And you can also check it on GoFundMe. You just look for Sebo Maravella or Sebo Karaci, and you'll be able to get it there. Yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for coming on the show and for all the great work that you're doing. We really do appreciate it. And best of luck with your handout today. I believe you're starting off at the Johannesburg Town Hall.
Yeah, it's just restarting off at Johannesburg Town Hall, walking all the way through Helen Joseph, going through N Street, and it's going to be a very fun day. I mean, today is always great in the great work that we've done. And thank you so much also for having me. Thank you.
My absolute pleasure. You have a fantastic day and stay safe.
Thank you. Stay safe too. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye. That was Sebo Karaci from Karaci Clothing. Really fantastic initiative that they're up with. And they are handing out those masks today from about 1 o'clock. They say it's going to be about a half an hour to an hour, starting off at Johannesburg Town Hall. If you would like to support or just follow Sebo, please do so. Like you mentioned, on Instagram, Karaci Clothing. That's Caraci Clothing. Or you can go find them on GoFundMe.
Damien Schmidt on the Midday...